And namaskar. I am Vishitara Pure, student of 10th standard here in front of you. As we all know, India is a diverse country. If we move from one state to another, we can find different forms of art, festivals, languages, etc. So here I am with my friends to discuss about it. So we will compare two such states. One is our home, Maharashtra, and the another, Orissa. So let's see.
Namaskara. I am Purvaja Deshmukh of class 10th Noble here with my group to present the comparison between Odisha and Maharashtra. I am here for the subject of L2, that is Sanskrit.
Prabhata. My name is Janavi Mohd. I am from 10th Noble. Temple forms the most important aspects of life in the Hindu community: religious, cultural, educational and social. The facets of Hindu temple not only focus on the goals of enlightenment and liberation, but also on the principles of design and construction and architecture and decorative form as well. So, here I am with the subject mathematics and topic are temple architecture of Odisha and Maharashtra. Thank you.
Good morning, this is Yubhya Patil from class 10th Noble. States of Odisha and Maharashtra have many golden pages of history. Some of them are death of Afzal Khan, war of Kalinga, war of Kondana, etc. So I am here for the topic assessment.
Namaskaram, I am Sumit Malode of class 10 Nobel from Prabhat Kid School. I am here with my group and my subject is science and my topic is food and resources.
सर्वेभ्यः नमो नमः। अहं पूर्वजा देशमुख, प्रभात किड्स विद्यालयस्य दशमी कक्षायाः छात्रा अस्मि। अद्य अहम् अत्र ओरिस्सा प्रान्तस्य प्रमुख उत्सवानां तथा कलानां परिचयं प्रस्तुत करोमि। ओरिस्सा प्रान्तस्य प्रमुख उत्सवाः एतानि सन्ति। प्रथमः, रथयात्रा। एतत् ओरिस्सा प्रान्तस्य सर्वप्रमुखः उत्सवः अस्ति। एतत् उत्सवः भगवान् जगन्नाथं समर्पितः अस्ति। यः विष्णुः कृष्णस्य च अवतारः मान्यते। जनाः भगवान् कृष्णं बलरामं सुभद्रां च रथयात्रां पूजयन्ते। एतत् उत्सवः द्वौ मासौ पूर्वादेव प्रारम्भते। ओरिस्साप्रान्तस्य जनाः सक्रियरूपेण रथयात्रां सहभागिनः सन्ति। बहवः जनाः भक्तिभावेन रथं कर्षति। रथकर्षणात् पुण्यं मोक्षं च प्राप्नुवन्ति इति जनानां मनोभावना अस्ति। द्वितीयः, नवरात्रि। नवरात्रि ओरिस्सा राज्यस्य प्रमुखोत्सवः अस्ति। सम्पूर्णदेशे अपि एतत् उत्सवः उत्साहेन मानयन्ते। एतत् उत्सवः सामाजिकं धार्मिकं रूपेण मान्यन्ते। नवरात्रि उत्सव अश्विन्मासे तथैव कार्तिकमासे आगच्छन्ति। सम्पूर्णनगरं सुशोभितं कुर्वन्ति। संघटित भूत्वा भगवत्याः श्रद्धाभावेन आराधनां कुर्वन्ति। अस्मिन् उत्सवे बहवः जनाः उत्साहेन सहभागिनाः सन्ति। तृतीय, कोणार्क महोत्सव। कोणार्क नृत्य महोत्सव सूर्यमन्दिरस्य सुन्दरतां ओरिस्सा नृत्यस्य सुन्दरतां च प्रदर्शयति। एतत् उत्सवः कोणार्क मन्दिरस्य प्राचीनसुन्दरतायां श्रद्धाञ्जलिम् अर्पितुं मान्यन्ते। कोणार्क नृत्य महोत्सव ओरिस्सा नृत्य अकादमी द्वारा आयोजितः। कुशलाः नर्तकाः अस्मिन् उत्सवे सहभागिनः सन्ति। विदेशः जनाः अपि एतत् महोत्सवः द्रष्टुम् आगच्छन्ति। दिसंबर मासस्य प्रथम सप्ताहे एतत् उत्सवः मान्यन्ते। चतुर्थः संक्रांति। एतत् उत्सवः कृषिकार्यार्थं शुभावहम् अस्ति। जनाः एतत् उत्सवे सूर्यदेवे तथा वरुणदेवस्य आराधनां कुर्वन्ति। सर्वे जनाः अतीव उत्साहेन एतत् उत्सवे सहभागिनः सन्ति। एतत् उत्सवः जनवरी मासे आगच्छति। जनाः स्वस्थ समृद्ध जीवनाय सूर्यदेवस्य प्रार्थनां कुर्वन्ति, नैवेद्यम् अर्पयन्ति च। पञ्चमः राजा पर्व। संपूर्ण ओडिशा राज्ये एतत् उत्सवः मान्यन्ते। एतत् उत्सवः पृथ्वीं समर्पितः अस्ति। कृषिकार्ये समृद्धि कामनार्थम् एतत् उत्सवः मान्यन्ते। पृथिव्यां रक्षणं संवर्धनम् एतत् पर्वस्य प्रमुख उद्देश्यः अस्ति। एतत् उत्सवः जुलै मासे मान्यन्ते।
Odisha is a land of many ancient temples. The capital city Bhubaneswar is dotted with more than 700 ancient temples. Among all temples of Odisha, the Lingaraja temple at Bhubaneswar deserves special mention. It bears architectural splendor and is regarded as one of the best archaeological monument. The Lingaraja temple is the largest temple in Odisha. The majestic Lingaraja temple has four frontal projected sections, namely the Deola, Jagamohana, Natamandira and Bhogamandapa. The central tower of temple is 180 feet. The temple is enshrined with a spacious compound wall of laterite measuring 520 feet by 465 feet. The wall is 7.5 feet thick and surmounted by plain slant coping. The complex of temple has 150 smaller shrines in its spacious courtyard. The Bhogamandapa, that is Hall of Offering, measures 56.25 feet from outside and has four doors from its side. The Natamandira, that is Festival Hall, measures 50 feet by 50 feet from outside and have one main and two side entrances. The Jagamohana, that is Assembly Hall, measures 55 by 50 feet from outside and has a 30 meter tall roof. The hall even has a pyramidal roof made up of several horizontal layers. The Rekha has a 60 meter tall pyramidal tower over the sanctum. The sanctum is square in shape from inside. While the state of Maharashtra has credit to its landmark in the evolution of Indian temple architecture, there are about 5,624 temples in Maharashtra. Among the temples of Maharashtra, Siddhivinayak Temple is one of the top religious places and historical monument in Mumbai, the capital of Maharashtra. Sri Siddhivinayak Temple is dedicated to Lord Ganesha and is a most iconic place in Mumbai. The idol of Lord Ganesha is carved out single piece of black stone and is 2.5 feet tall. The 6 lakh square feet of space has been constructed the Vinayak Temple. Siddhivinayak Temple is 120 feet in length and 71 feet in height and 80 feet in width. The original structure of temple was a small 3.6 by 3.6 meter square brick structure with a dome-shaped brick shikara. The 2,550 temple complex have two 3.6 meter deepamalas. It had an 30 by 40 square meters in size on the eastern and southern side of temple. Apart from it, 37 other smaller gilded domes adorn the temple structure as well. Thank you.
Odisha, formerly called Odisha, state of India, surrounded by Jharkhand and West Bengal to the north, by the Bay of Bengal to east, and by the states of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana to the south, and Chhattisgarh to the west. In late 2011, the state's name was officially changed from Odisha to Odisha. Its total population is 4.71 crore. The language spoken in Odisha is known as Odia. Climate in Odisha. It is located in a climatic region known as tropical wet dry. Odisha has high temperature, high humidity, medium to high rainfall and short and mild winters, soil and rivers. The coastal plains are formed of alluvial soil deposited by many rivers flowing to Bay of Bengal. Main rivers in Odisha are Mahanadi, Brahmani, etc. Odisha's saltwater Chilka Lake is one of the largest lagoons in India. In Odisha, Hindus are present in a majority, whereas Muslims and Christians are in minorities. Dance form practice in Odisha. Odissi dance, Dalkhai dance, Mahari dance, Ranappa dance, etc. History. Odisha is gone by a various name, most notably Utkala, Kalinga, Udradesa. In the 4th century, Mahapandama Nanda, founder of Nanda industry, conquered Kalinga, but the Nanda rule was short-lived. The Mauryan Emperor Ashoka invaded Kalinga and fought one of the greatest wars of Asian history. He then renounced war, became a Buddhist, and preached peace and non-violence in and outside India. The Mughal Emperor Akbar wrested Odisha from the Afghans in 1590-92. When the Mughal Empire fell, in some part of Odisha remained under the Nawabs of Bengal, but the greater part passed to the Marathas. The Bengal sector came under British after the Battle of Plassey. Then the Maratha sector was conquered by the British in 1803. Odisha became a state of India in 1950.
Now, let me tell you about the food and resources of the state Odisha. Dalma. Dalma, the wholesome food of Odisha. Dalma is essentially dal cooked with an assortment of vegetables and spices. Apart from being a part of the main course, people relish the dish with a variety of dishes like dalma with pitha and dalma with vada. It has a culinary tradition spanning centuries. Majority of the people from Odisha are non-vegetarians and the fish forms an integral part of their tradition cuisine. Oriya dishes are rich and varied and rely on the local ingredients. Rice, both sun-dried and parboiled, is the staple food of the people in the state. However, the eating patterns are slightly changed in the urban areas, but they do prepare traditional dishes from the Oriya cuisine during festival occasions. The cuisine of Odisha has a distinctive cooking style, and the same is followed in the preparation of dishes. A typical main course consists of rice and chapati, along with dal bhaji, bharta, and ambila, sakara, and dessert. Now, talking about the resources in Odisha, the state has plenty of all types of natural resources like forest, mineral, water, and land. Talking about the water resources, Odisha has a number of big and small rivers flowing across the state. All the rivers end in Bay of Bengal. Out of all rivers, Mahanadi is the biggest one. It is originated at Amarkantak Plateau of Madhya Pradesh. The length of the river is 858 km. Thank you.